Hey everyone, Ryan here, or M&R Productions, and today we're taking a look at an absolute behemoth with the 2021 version of the LEGO Space Shuttle. There have been plenty of LEGO Space Shuttles in the past, but I don't think any of them are really going to compare to what we have here today with set number 10283 as part of the 18 plus lineup for LEGO. We have the Space Shuttle, and we also have the Hubble Space Telescope as the two main builds in the set, along with a stand, and there's also a couple plaques to display alongside of these. That aside, the set does have 2,354 pieces, which is a lot of pieces. It's going to take quite a while to build. I would estimate 4 to 6 hours for most people. And for that piece count, you're going to be paying $200 in the United States, which I think is a pretty fair price for this set, but we can get a little bit more into that later. As of release, this set is currently a LEGO.com and LEGO Store exclusive. If you want to buy it on LEGO.com, I'll put my affiliate link down in the description below. But in a few months, it'll probably show up on Amazon and Target and Walmart.com and other retailers you may want to purchase it at. Otherwise, the box art is rather beautiful. It shows just all black with a few stars on the top right and the top left there where the NASA Space Shuttle Discovery logo is as well. This thing's beautiful. I think it's really big and I'm really excited. And like I said, there have been other space shuttles in the past, but just none of them are really going to compare to this. This is so much better than even like the second best space shuttle, which would probably be the 2010 version for most people. And that one was really good, but this one is just immaculate. And we'll get into that. Obviously, you got the display stand and plaque shown off a little bit better here on the back of the box with some measurements. The space shuttle program logo on the top right, and then alternate angles of the space shuttle, as well as in real life versions of the Hubble Space Telescope and the Space Shuttle Discovery there with the rocket booster. I kind of wish this set had the rocket booster. I do see it would add like another $200, but I really like the 2010 version that has the rocket booster with it, because to me that's the complete look for the space shuttle. But obviously this one's going for a completely different vibe, which is perfectly fine, but I want the other one. So I think I'm going to end up buying that one anyway, but this one's still really cool and I'm very excited to take a look at it. Let's unbox it and see what that's like. While I don't expect the unboxing to vary too much from other bigger LEGO sets, you know, it's always worth showing with these big ones though, because I think people find it a little bit more interesting. I think it's a little bit more interesting for me too. And you never know. Sometimes there's some surprises thrown in with sets like these and some oddities. So it looks like first off, we've got a whole box. So this kind of keeps the rigidity of the actual box. So we've got a white box inside and then the rest of the contents will just be held loosely within, and it looks like the instruction manual will actually be held separately within the white box, which also looks like it's going to be the first thing you're going to want to take out. You can leave the other bags inside because the white box is going to hold a lot of your lower, because the white box is going to hold all of your lower numbered bags and the instruction manual, which is all you need to start. Wow, that's a lot of gold and silver stickers there, and the instruction manual packed very nicely in there. So that's what it looks like to unbox a set. Nothing out of the ordinary for LEGO, I would say. Let's go ahead and build it, and I'll see you guys when it's done. The finished space shuttle and Hubble telescope are both quite beautiful, but for the building process, the instructions look like this. They come in all black paper, which I personally prefer, but LEGO is actually going to be getting rid of here soon. So this may be one of the last sets with an all black instruction manual. And I do find that the opening text is a little bit underwhelming. There's just not a lot of it. There's only a few paragraphs about little different things and basically nothing on the design process of the set. I mean, there's a little bit of what the designer enjoyed, but not too much there, but they kind of make up for it along the way with some did you know facts about the space shuttle and the Hubble telescope as you're building it. So there's definitely more to the instruction manual info that meets the eye at the beginning, but I found it to be a little bit underwhelming at the front end, but I think it's kind of made up for it. But that's the manual. But as for the set itself, it's basically the Space Shuttle Discovery and then the bonus build Hubble Space Telescope. I consider this a bonus build because I don't really care about it. I mean, you may care more about it. I know the Hubble Space Telescope is a very important thing in the history of humanity and all the great images it's taken, but I really bought this for the space shuttle. This being included was like purely bonus to me. But it is really nice. It's really cool that you get what I would have easily paid $200 for on its own in the Space Shuttle Discovery, and then you get the Hubble Space Telescope, which is probably a $30 or $40 value. Just, it feels like it was thrown in, but it's obviously part of the package. Starting with this display plaque, it's got its launch date. It has the launch mass, which is a very heavy telescope at that. The one I owned when I was little was maybe like 20 pounds. It's got the velocity it's moving around the Earth, and then the deploy altitude, which is 350 miles above the surface, so pretty high up there. But it's a very beautiful model. It's got solar panels on either side of it, which are rotatable to match wherever the sun is in whatever way you got to do that. It's got the actual lens of the telescope here, which can actually be covered up when need be to protect it. And then you have these little things here. I'm not really sure what they are. I assume there some sort of thrust to make sure it's facing the correct way when you need to make it face the correct way. And then you have the back end here. And it's actually really beautiful with a bunch of silver on it. It's not like the actual old chrome reflective silver that Lego used to have, but it is a nice kind of happy medium for a Lego silver. And it matches decently well with the light gray that it's kind of intertwined with. And you can actually remove this from its stand here. So it's got a little display stand. It's small, but you can see this is what it looks like on its own. And you can actually place this inside the payload bay of the space shuttle. We'll do that in a little bit, but this is what it includes to facilitate that. The Space Shuttle Discovery's display plaque has a bit more information than the Hubble Space Telescope because it's a bit bigger. It's more akin to the Lego Star Wars UCS style display plaque you can see there with the Slave One or the UCS B-Wing there. It's got that vibe to it for sure. It definitely takes a lot of inspiration from there, which is good, I think. So we have the wingspan. We have how many launches it did, which was 39, which is probably more than I would have guessed. It was active from 1984 to 2011. Its orbital velocity, which is hella fast. Max altitude, which is 350 miles, which is also the same height that they launched the telescope from. We have Earth orbits, 5,830, probably less than I would have guessed if we were just playing that game. Time in space, 1 year, 22 hours, 39 minutes, and 33 seconds. So quite a while spent up above our heads for the Space Shuttle Discovery. And I believe this particular space shuttle, if you ever want to see it, is on display at the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum. I know they have another space shuttle up at the Kennedy Space Center visitors complex near where I live, and I would love to go see that. It's been a while. So we'll start here on the very front. We actually have what looks like just kind of a, you know, I was assuming it before I did my research, that this was just kind of the way the set had to be designed, that you had to see these Technic pins. But no, these Technic pins that you're seeing are actually representative of the forward reaction control engines, and so are these two studs on either side of the nose of the shuttle here. And that is just so that when you're in space and you need to make a slight tweak, you can do that and not have to use like the full engines or anything, and you need little ones anyway because you're in space and you're weightless, basically, to just slightly adjust yourself. So you have little engines basically on the nose of the shuttle, which allow you to adjust the angle of the shuttle while you're up in space doing whatever you need to be doing. And I will say the build for this is really satisfying as you're going along. Like, all these panels putting on here are very, very fun to do. You have a little sticker here, and on the other side it's going to say Discovery, so you do have the name of the shuttle plastered on it so that you know. You do have a printed windshield piece here at the very front, which shows the inside of the cockpit where, of course, the astronauts are going to be. There's a couple printed pieces on top there with little hatches, which look pretty good. Having removed that top piece, you can see there are four chairs inside, as well as plenty of control panels for the astronauts, because there are a ton of electronics inside of the cockpit of the space shuttle to control the dang thing. And I'm not sure if these are new prints or not. They're new to me, but they might not be new prints overall. These ones in the back aren't new, but there are a couple of prints in this that definitely look new as far as control panels go, and it's rather good looking. So I like that it's done in this very nice micro scale. It's not minifigure scale, which makes sense. It doesn't have to be. And yes, if we remove this whole top section here with that interior included, there is actually a second interior section below that with another seat for your fifth astronaut or passenger, and you can get a better view of like the back control panels in there. So very cool interior space in the micro scale here. Moving back, you have this really smooth paneling and surface, which looks really good. I'm really surprised how few studs show on the exterior of the space shuttle here, and that makes sense given that the space shuttle itself doesn't actually have studs on it, but obviously Lego takes some liberties a lot of the time to make it look like a Lego set. They leave a lot of studs on the exterior of it, but in this particular case, they really tiled it off really nicely. You can see using cheese slopes and some of the larger slope pieces that are more rounded here, it looks really, really good. You have a very large USA tile there. It's a 6x6 tile, and that is printed. So is this 1x8 brick here that says United States, and then you have a NASA sticker on the curved panel up above, which adds an important bit of accuracy to the set to give it the correct markings. You do have the payload bay here, which you can open one and two, and of course, it's very reflective on the inside. Now, these stickers were probably the worst part about the building process for this set. They're just kind of a pain to put on either side, and there are a lot of them. So that's definitely something I would warn against, or just be ready for. Like, it's not something you can avoid building this set unless you're just not going to put the stickers on, which I'm sure it would look fine without the stickers. It'd just be all white instead of silver. But for me as a Lego collector, I always build it exactly the way the instructions say, and the instructions say put a bunch of annoying stickers on. I'm going to put a bunch of annoying stickers on. Now, on the inside, we do have a couple more printed pieces there with some 1x1 tiles that look pretty good. That's just added detail that I don't think was necessarily necessary, but it's there. You also have a window port to allow you to see into the payload bay from around the cockpit of the shuttle, which is really great. Nice little detail. You have a little hatch down there as well, so you can access it if this was like the real space shuttle. You have the very large and long canid arm. I think that's the name of it, if I'm pronouncing it correctly, like the proper name, but it's essentially the space shuttle's arm. It's got a few different hinge points to allow for some really good mobility within the shuttle and outside of the shuttle to move whatever the payload is. So in this set's case, it's going to be the Hubble telescope. However, because we are not in weightlessness here on Earth, you cannot actually hold the telescope up with this arm. In space, you could. Obviously, not the actual Lego one. Like, this is way too flimsy. This is not holding anything, maybe other than a couple more bricks on the bottom of it, right? So the rest of the payload is relatively empty. There's not a lot going on. There's a US flag in the back. Then you have, I believe these are cameras that are supposed to be stationed up on top of the shuttle's payload bay so that they can see what's going on in there if they need to. So if you want to get the Hubble Space Telescope in here for display, and it's not the way that I would prefer to display it because I actually prefer displaying it just as the shuttle, but you can display it with it actually moving the telescope. So let me show you how that's done. So first we're gonna have to close this on the front, and we're gonna actually take off the solar panels, which don't seem to wanna come off properly at times. You'll see it'll take the whole brick off. So I guess we'll just do it the hard way. So you get the solar panels off. It's a Lego set. It's not gonna be perfect, but boy, is it a bit annoying. You actually have to pull this out, which has like a little control panel on it as well on both sides. And you'll notice there's some studs in there. You need to do a couple other things. You have to pull these little clip pieces out because they are otherwise going to be in the way. You're going to place this end inside of the telescope like that. And you'll notice it basically creates a little stand. We'll get to that in a second. You also get these gold pieces, which are going to replace the solar panels on either side, one and two like that. And then the female adapter, and then the female side of the clip is going to go into these bits here, which is where you would otherwise put the stand for the Hubble Space Telescope, but because you're just displaying it in the actual shuttle, it's a little bit different here. So these are gonna actually be where the control arm is going to quote unquote attach into. And you'll notice open studs here. And all you have to do is push this down right inside of there. And even with this in here, it remains balanced basically because this is pretty well centered as far as weight goes for this. You don't have to worry about it like causing the shuttle to tip within the stand. It should be just fine. You can actually take the control arm and place it within one of those clip pieces there. So just like that, the control arm is looking like it's holding the Hubble Space Telescope. However, it is not obviously supporting the weight of it. The weight of it is supported by this little black stand here. So obviously, if we were in real space, you could probably pull something like this off, but you have to use this stand on Earth because you just can't do it otherwise. Now, while we're up here and out of the way, you remember that USA sticker on the left. Well, there's a NASA Discovery sticker on the right, so a little bit of a different look on this side. So just in case you needed to know, the instructions do guide you through how to attach and detach the Hubble Space Telescope from the inside of the shuttle, so you can do it with the instructions. You don't have to come back and watch this video in the future if you forget. It's a pretty easy process, and it's outlined relatively simply in the instructions for you to really just figure out on your own. I think an important question to answer for most people is, will this actually fit in the payload bay and close up properly? And the answer to that is yes, close. To yes, it kind of, sort of, not really. I mean, I think if you finagle it around a little bit more, maybe if we actually remove that clip, that might be the offender right there. You can almost close it perfectly. I'm sure there might be a better angle, but it is very close to, if not actually doable. Like I said, you can see there's still a bit of a gap there, and I don't know how annoying you're going to particularly find that, but you can actually fit the payload in the payload bay, which I think is important, but it's just definitely not the ideal way to display it. If you're not going to have it out like we just had it on the black stand, I don't see any particular reason to keep it in there all hidden up. Just put it on its own display stand with the solar panels and have it looking snazzy next to your space shuttle. I think that's the way to go. So looking on to the very back of the shuttle, you actually do have a few more features built into this. I really like that they built the engines in at an angle. I know it's hard to tell on camera, especially when it's on the stand. Maybe if I hold it flat, you'll see it better. But the engines are at their proper kind of slightly upward facing out the back angle, which looks really great and accurate to the actual space shuttle. And these are the three main engines on the set. They're kind of built with one of those Lego barrel pieces in this dark pearl or gunmetal gray. It looks really, really good. Now, up here on the main fin, it's pretty brick-built, technic-y. It's got a lot of different pieces in here. I don't think it necessarily looks perfect. It may actually be the weakest link design-wise on the shuttle here. You can debate that in the comments. But as far as an actual functionality to it, it is the rudder and speed brake. And so as the rudder, it can turn right and left. And I believe the functionality as a speed brake is that it can kind of split out like this and create a bit of drag as it's going through the air. So then you close this back up and you can see how it kind of increases the aerodynamics of the fin there on the back. So decently good looking fin, not perfect, but decently good looking at that. And then you actually have a couple of, these are called elevons on the right and left wings here. You can see them move up and down in unison here. You can actually use this engine here at the top to twist. And so as you want to turn the space shuttle to the left or to the right, you twist this. And so you can see they move opposite of each other, which is just the way you would want to do it. You also have some control engines here. All these little black spots, I think, are just different little thrusters that allow you to control the space shuttle's angle a little bit better, kind of like the ones on the front. And you have a final flap on the bottom here, which can move up and down, but it also has what is probably the craziest feature of this space shuttle, and that is that it literally drops the landing gear. So we'll get rid of the stand. We'll look at the bottom of the shuttle here for a second, and you can see it has landing gear. Yes, great looking landing gear, just folded right up and in. And you know, when I built this set and I had it done, I was looking at it and I'm like, pulling at the landing gear, I can't get it out. I'm like, it just doesn't work. What's going on? That's because all I have to do is push in on this from the back and the landing gear will pop on down and out. So I'll try to give you a good angle of this. We'll push in on it. And just like that, all three pieces of the landing gear pop out and down really, really quick. They don't fold back in by like pulling this or doing anything with it. You actually have to push them back up manually, but they kind of lock into place, which is really great. So let me show you this from the inside. You would think this would be impossible just looking at how thin the model is, but it's actually a pretty ingenious bit of design, which, like I said, I didn't figure out until I was done building this building. I'm like, what is this whole panel here for? Because this bit of tiling, and then there's like a plate underneath, and then there's a couple of pieces that will kind of jut out from this, I think up here at the front especially, that basically run into what deploys the landing gear. And so when you push this, you'll see the plate move essentially forward and the landing gear drop down as it goes. So you can see it moving there. So when it moves forward, it drops landing gear down. See, this is the landing gear in here. And again, as it moves forward, you can see it pops it forward, and as does the one at the front. So a very crazy way to do the landing gear there, and a really ingenious way to build it in. And this front piece of landing gear actually does have a slight bit of movement to it, which is great, because these back two don't really, which allows you to, as you're moving the space shuttle around, turn it just ever so slightly, turn the space shuttle so that it can maneuver its way around on the ground in a realistic fashion. I really love the way that it looks on the landing gear. I think that it's a really great and smooth function, and it works really surprisingly well. And it actually does lean down slightly forward, just like the actual space shuttle. So they got that down to a T as well. This is far and away the best space shuttle that LEGO has ever created. And it has a Hubble Space Telescope as what to me is a bonus build. So if you were thinking about buying this, if you were on the edge, I don't know what I got to say to push you over the edge. I don't know if this video did the talking for itself, but this is an excellent, wonderful, literally out of this world LEGO set. It's incredible. I mean, I love it. I love space shuttle. Obviously, I live near where they launched it, and I watched them launch from my backyard as a kid all the time, so I have that connection to it. And it's a really great LEGO display piece on top of that. It's just like people recognize, oh, that's the space shuttle, and it's a really good LEGO model on top of that, and it's got the Hubble Space Telescope. I just, for $200, I think this is a crazy deal of a set. No minifigs, maybe the biggest downside for some people. Maybe you wanted to see some of the famous astronauts that maybe flew on the Space Shuttle Discovery, and maybe we get something like that in the future from some other set somewhere down the line 10 years from now, I don't know. But there just aren't a lot of minifigures in these NASA sets in general most of the time, so getting no minifigs to me is not much of a downside here, because I didn't expect any. I would call this set a 10 out of 10. I mean, it's very close at that. I mean, it's maybe got a few issues, like the Technic pieces being blue on the side sometimes. Like, that's still an issue with some LEGO sets, but I mean, it's a really accurate, really well done LEGO space shuttle that really pays homage to the shuttle program in its 40th anniversary here in 2021. So let me know what you guys think about it in the comments section below. I'm in love with it. I would certainly recommend buying it if you were thinking about it. If you guys enjoyed this review of the LEGO Space Shuttle Discovery, make sure you hit that like button, and if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.